Hello YouTube, and you probably haven't seen my 80s Philips for a long time, and this video is supposed to show how I take care of my old vacuums, and I wouldn't need to do this if this couldn't have this kind of back setup. So I have been using this just with this removable back. So I am going to use my canister setup Sark to clean that Philips. So this is completely clean, that pin, like you can see. So first thing what we are going to do is take this back out, and there is something, yes, that was the front wheel holding that front cover. So this is very dirty. So let's start from that and take the Sark to clean it. So first thing is to switch it on, and then I go and soak that. this is very clean now. And now we move to the vacuum itself. So we have to clean the inside. Well, it's not very dirty, but we do that anyway. This part is dirty because when you have that back there, obviously dirt will stick to this, so let's do that. Okay, now we can put this clean bag into there, and this is different than other packet vacuums because this has that very big so-called premotor filter, but should have inside in it that paper bag what they used to use in the 80s. So this is my modification, so I can use actual bags in this, and I am going to use that or do that in the future. Now comes to the outside, and let's make sure that you can see that. And yes, it is Kirby dusting brush. This is fantastic, very very soft natural hair. So let's clean the outside. Okay, Philips is looking very good now, and I am in this old vacuum team because, like you know, there is coming one very old vacuum. Well, I don't know how you feel about very old vacuum. You might think that it's pretty old or somewhat old, but in my opinion, that Electro Helios, what is coming to my channel, is very old because it is late 70s to mid, not mid, late 70s to early 80s vacuum. So that green, very traditional Lux vacuum, Electrolux also called it. So Electro Helios, but Electrolux also. So yes, and this has one same thing with that, and that's the sound what this makes. But let's see before we fire that Philips up, what we beacon up. So there was coin in the pipe of the shark, so that's quite a lot of stuff from there. So, and I also have new filter set up because those are very worn, those filters what I have for this shark. So there is two of these, one layer and second layer of these foam filters. So I can already see that this is getting dirty, but the first layer is still very clean. So of course that is how you make sure that the motor doesn't get dirty. So let's leave that there. And let's fire up this Philips. And this is what I absolutely love about this. Certain old vacuums, not all old vacuums sound like this, but many of them do. So listen to that wind down sound. It is silky, silky smooth, and I hope that the oncoming Electro Helios sounds like it should sound, because I have seen those videos about it. But yes, there is coming all kind of videos before the actual unboxing of that Electro Helios. So yes, and well, just a reminder, this is Philips sound compared to the Shark sound. So Philips on the full power. So that Sark is not bad sounding. It's quieter than most Sarks, what are absolutely terrible screamer vacuums. I like Sarks, but well, they can't match even close what these 80s vacuums can do. So yes, and I am taking English lessons in my school, and there is so much going on in my school, so I always do videos when I can, but I mean, I am very busy with my school. It's not just that computer thing, what I am learning, it is so much more. And you need to know the English very well to be good with computers. So this was non-edited video, and my speech again wasn't perfect, but yes, I hope you enjoy this, and I certainly enjoy these old vintage vacuums, but are made to last. So thanks for watching, and goodbye.